Hola amigos y amigas, ¿cómo están hoy? Welcome back to another grammar lesson with teacher Catalina. Before we go into our salón de clase, don't forget to click me gusta and subscribe so you and I can continue to learn Spanish together. Got it? Did you click? Muy bien. Today we are continuing on our conjugation journey, but today we're going to be focusing on some special kinds of verbs. They are irregular verbs, but we call them go verbs. G-O verbs. Go verbs. So you're probably wondering, why would we call them go verbs? And that is such a perfectly valid question. So I'm going to answer it. And it's simple, because there is a go in one of the conjugations, and we have to remember to add it. Oh my goodness, the teacher Catalina said there was a go in the conjugations. Where? Don't worry, we're about to go into the salón de clase and I'm gonna show you exactly where that go goes. So here's the trick. You are going to like today's verbs because the only thing that changes is in the yo form. That's what's going to make it an irregular. There is a go in the yo form and only in the yo form. The rest of the forms conjugate like regular AR, ER, and IR verbs. So let's start with the verb hacer. Hacer, to do or to make. Hacer, that H is silent. Hacer is a go verb, which means that the yo form is going to have a go. So let's look at it. The conjugation would be hago, hago. Yo hago. Now, here's the trick. The rest of the conjugations, we treat it like a regular ER verb. The only thing that changes in go verbs, basically what makes them irregular, it's that go in the yo form and only in the yo form. Now remember, hacer is a regular ER verb. So let's look at the conjugations. Tú haces. Tú haces una torta deliciosa. Tú haces una torta deliciosa. Él, ella, and usted. Regular ER verb in this conjugation. So it would be hace. Ella hace una ensalada para el almuerzo. Ella hace una ensalada para el almuerzo. Nosotros hacemos. Nosotros hacemos una sopa de verdura para la cena. Nosotros hacemos una sopa de verdura para la cena. Vosotros hacéis. Vosotros hacéis un pan riquísimo. Vosotros hacéis un pan riquísimo. And finally, ellos, ellas, and ustedes. We'll use the conjugation of the verb hacer, and that would be hacen. Ustedes hacen carne y papas para la cena. Ustedes hacen carne y papas para la cena. And that is how you conjugate a go verb. So remember, go verbs have a go only in the yo form, and the rest of the conjugations, you treat it like a regular verb. This happens in the present tense, and there's a couple of other verbs that I want you to pay attention to. Let's do another one together, shall we? Okay, you guys, let's do the verb salir. Salir. Salir means to go out. Now remember, salir is a go verb, but it's also an IR verb. What does it mean to be a go verb? Simply that there is going to be a go in the yo form. So the conjugation for yo would be salgo. Salgo. There's your go. That's what makes it a go verb. Yo salgo de mi casa a las 8 de la mañana. Yo salgo de mi casa a las 8 de la mañana. Now, tú. Do we put a go? Do we do anything? What happens? That's right. We treat it like a regular IR verb. So we're gonna say, tú sales. And we're gonna do the same thing for the rest because go verbs don't have any other changes that we need to worry about except for the yo form. So él, ella, usted, sale. Nosotros and nosotras. Remember, this is an IR verb, so we will say salimos. Nosotros salimos de la escuela a las 3 de la tarde. Nosotros salimos de la escuela a las 3 de la tarde. Vosotros salís. And ellos, ellas, and ustedes salen. Salen. Ellas salen. Ellos salen. So now you have all of the conjugations of the verb salir. You made sure that you added the go to the yo form because it is a go verb. And then you did the rest of the conjugations like a regular IR verb in the present tense. So you have salgo with a go, sales, sale, salimos, salís, and salen. And that again is how you conjugate go verbs. Okay, as usual, I want to give you a couple more verbs that have this change in the yo form, which are also called go verbs. Just make sure that you know what they mean and that you remember that we're going to follow the same rules. So take a look at all of these verbs that may be useful to you when you're in your Spanish class or when you're trying to communicate with somebody in Spanish. Again, remember to look at the meaning. And don't forget that those are go verbs. There will be a go only in the yo form. The rest of them, you treat it like regular AR, ER, and IR verbs. Fantástico! I am super proud of you. Look how far we've come together. We've conjugated all sorts of verbs, and we've made it through. Just like I know we will continue to make it through any other grammar and vocabulary lesson. So don't forget to click like and subscribe so you and I can continue to learn Spanish together. You always make me smile and I hope I make you smile too. Sonríe siempre. Adiós.